Nice to see you.
Also, the University of.
How do you do, sir?
Hello there.
See you.
See you.
Hi, Ted. How are you?
Hi.
Good to see you.
Really?
Hello.
Hi.
Good to see you. Likewise, good to see.
Well, please, yeah.
Right.
Right.
My Bible?
Well, as you see, we brought in a Google.
I'm sorry.
They're all feathered in agriculture, like, you know, one form or another, and hopefully that connection to the University of Chicago in 48 or 49.
North.
He's a professor emeritus at Chicago, Nobel Prize winner, member of the National Academy of Sciences, and been a very distinguished person as well as an agricultural economist, a critical note. And Gail Johnson on your right, also is at Chicago, formerly provost there, and he's in social sciences. Again, a very distinguished agricultural economist, among other things. Don Carlberg here, I've known quite as long, I've known Gail 40 now. He has worked with four secretaries of agriculture, among his other activities, and again, it's one of the best known agricultural economists we have. Bruce Gardner is one who's relatively new to me. He's at the University of Maryland, and has worked here, has been at the University of Chicago, University of North Carolina, and is here at, has been here at the Council of Economic Advisors. So they're the farmers we brought in. The reason for bringing them in is that we thought you might want to, at the summit, when they have a session that's relatively unstructured for people to bring up broad, long-range issues, that you might want to bring up agriculture, several subjects that we're going to propose to you as possibilities. And one reason for suggesting agriculture is that there's been a dramatic change in attitude toward agriculture in international course of discussion.
Just leave.
Happy there, okay. Good. Just check it. So,
sorry, back up, just go.
Oh, my.
Okay, all right, that's great, good. Variance, that's great, good. Good. Watch the main light one. Good, that's great.
Are you smiling?
Yes.
I'm smiling. Geez, George is laughing.
Not too happy. Doing good, fine. Now, a little change of pace here. Yes, that's right, that's quite a lot. So if you look at me, and I want you to look at your face. And you want to smile, let's try to smile.
You ignore me.
That's good. Okay, so if you look back, okay, that's good. This present thing, just poke your head a little bit. There we go, good. My toes down, I think. Definitely my timing's up there.
Yes.
How are you doing? Look up at the beginning of the story. That's good, good. All right, that's good, that's good. That's right, good. Nice big smile, that's good. And one more, good, good.
Jim, the taping is at 5.
One more. I was telling you about all the nice places where the bike and bike people also.
We got you coming in.
Thank you. Thank you.
Then you shake hands, right? Okay.
I'm good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'll grab your stuff and I'll take you and Mark down to the airline. So you go home. I go home. Yeah.
That's one frame when it says.
She's doing.
Work for constructive East-West relations to combat terrorism and also to show that we care about the drug problem. So I think in general the scene is a fairly positive one. This is an effort to depict the way in which the meetings at least are supposed to flow, and the heads of state may alter that flow. And Jim and I have been talking a little bit about altering it insofar as the finance and foreign ministers are concerned. But as you can see, the first box up here on the left under heads of state, it is thought that you would discuss East-West issues there and terrorism. Meanwhile, the finance ministers have been talking about economic things and foreign ministers regional matter. And then the next morning you have another meeting of heads only where more or less the same things would be getting discussed. And two statements that have been worked on, one of which is pretty much agreed to and the other of which is fairly well agreed to, would hopefully be finalized there and then issued at the end of the morning.
A little late here.
No, it's fine.
Hello, Billy.
You've been here
twice in 2 days. Good to see you. Hello, Billy. How are you?
Mr. President, we thank you for seeing us today. We, for some time, have wanted to stress to you the concern we have about what's going on in the energy-producing areas of the country, which have a responsibility providing our necessary domestic energy for the years to come. And I know you're aware of a lot of it, and I don't want to go back over it, but we've lost approaching 200,000 jobs in Houston, Texas in the last 2 to 4 years. And we're not really complaining about that. Those of us here are free market people, and we understand that. But we feel that there should be a concern nationwide for the loss of high-cost marginal production, which, when plugged, may never come back. And that's a resource that we are concerned about, the stripper wells, the tertiary, and heavy oil-type wells. And then we're concerned about maintaining in place a basic infrastructure of drilling capability and exploration capability, which, when it's gone, will be very difficult to put back in place again when prices do rise. We're also concerned about getting the government out of the way as much as we can, and I know you've always expressed sympathy for this, and there are a lot of things that we can do in that direction, like repeal the windfall profits tax, deregulate natural gas, which you said you support, and we applaud you for that. Repeal the fuel use act, we may not be unanimous on that, but to give a chance for unblocking as much as we can in those areas that are possible to us. And that will save administrative costs and free up extra monies. But we feel that we need extra incentives for the marginal production and extra incentives that we don't have today for the exploratory type activities that I mentioned. One thing we're not here to do today is to importune you about an oil tariff or an import fee. And we made that clear with our group. We weren't going to come here for any political purposes other than to tell you what we see as the problems and to encourage you to let us work with you on a plan, hopefully some sort of a Reagan administration energy policy that will take into account these problems that we have today and let us focus on how it's...
Hi, how are you? Let's get a picture here together.
Thank you.
Well, listen, good to see you. Thank you.
Jerry Colombo.
Hi, how are you? Nice to see you.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you.
And John Lewis.
Mr. President.
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you.
Well, nice to see you.
And Bill Bay, President, how are you?
Just fine.
Thank you. You look fine.
Well, I feel
very
good.
Very proud of you.
Thank you. All right.
Assemblyman Dennis Brown.
Mr. President.
Hello.
How are you? Thank you.
Frank Hill.
Frank Hill from Whittier.
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you. Thank you. Looks like you've done this before.
Senator
Ed Excuse me, where's Whittier?
Mr. President. Oh,
Orange County, how are you?
Well, Orange County, where the good Republicans go before they die.
Right.
Well, why don't I get in the middle of the group?
Yes, sir.
We go back a long way together.
We sure do.
And then his delegates to 76.
Everyone look right here, that's it. Thank you, sir.
And you're all running for re-election.
Yes,
we are. Yes, we are. We're going to take over by 97 redistrict. That's our leader.
That's great. That's what's really wrong. Our Congress and everything else, it'd be 50 years that the other side has been doing it.
When we draw the next lines, we'll take back the 6 they stole from us. We'll add 6 of our own and 5 more because of the census. It'll be a net swing of 17. You would have won the Contra vote.
We're going to spend between $3 and $5 million on assembly races to take over that house.
So I just want to show you something that will that will demonstrate to you the power of entrepreneurship. That was great.
That is so great.
Governor, I mean, President, Pat has a story for you about Gaddafi was injured.
Yeah, and the rate, he was getting a drink of water in the toilet seat, fell on him.
God bless you for doing that. Absolutely. We're really
absolutely
proud of
you. Proud of the Americans.
But you know, there's one thing, we can't rule out that one of our bombs accidentally hit those civilians, that civilian target. But at the same time, nobody can write off the fact also that they could have done it themselves with their own missiles.
Mm-hmm.
Because we had planes up that were offsetting there electronically so that they could not, their radars would not target them on our planes. So they were just shooting them straight up in the air and they were coming straight down. And there was a picture up here and they made the picture available of one of them, part of a booster in the street that they claimed was a plane, part of a plane of ours that they shot down, is the booster from their rocket. So those things were coming back.
After all the murders he's committed, you don't have to feel defensive.
Yeah.
Not a bit.
I'm proud of you.
We sure are. Thank you very much.
You've been an inspiration to all of us in being involved in politics. You know, conservatives, especially, I think our parents didn't look too kindly on us getting involved in politics, but you made an honorable profession.
Well, bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thanks for your time.
You're off to the parties?
Yeah, right. Head out to Bali first, and then to Tokyo. That'll be a total of about 22,000-something miles.
Mm-hmm. Can you get some rest?
Yes, we're going to do it. We're going to stop overnight in Los Angeles. That's 3 hours difference. And I'm going to go a couple more and stop over a night, two nights in Hawaii. And then we go on to Bali. Well, we refuel and go on, but then go on to Bali. And then from Bali, when we go to Japan, that's back an hour closer to our time. But the whole thing is
it's a trip.
I'm still trying to pin it down whether it's 13 hours or 12 hours difference.
Trade, the big issue, trade.
That and terrorism. I think it's time for us to be really serious and wrap it all together. We can do it.
Thank you. We'll miss you on the Rancheros track. You're done here.
They'll be talking back.
Well, for now.
You're going to do some congressional races this year?
Oh, sure.
We visited with Ben Weber. He's in a tough place.
Yeah,
Minnesota. Yeah, given us
they've really done. Anyway, we've been posed on your time long enough. Thank you,
Mr. President. Thanks for visiting with us.
Thank you very much.
Whoops.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Good to see you again, President.
Sometimes.
Thank you very much.
Very well.
Thank you, Mr. President. Appreciate it.
I wish we had a budget system here like we have all.
If you had the blue pencil, things would be a lot different.
Yes.
And Duke had the lead for 1,267?
1,263 vetoes. He beat your record.
And Vito.
Just to mention.
Yeah, minus 943.
He's a headache.
Anyway,
thank you.
Bye-bye.